Hi, welcome back once again to CBSE Board Economics. My name is Saddam Hussain. I welcome you all. Today we discuss another important topic, that is law of demand. This is such a universal topic. It will help you in your common life. Of course, it's very important for the students who are doing economics, whether they're doing it at lower classes or when they go for higher studies. Law of demand. What exactly is law? Why do we call it law of demand? Because it is universally true. Laws are always universally true. What exactly is law of demand? Law of demand states keeping all the other factors affecting demand for a commodity, all the other determinants, factors, we keep it constant. So they call it in French as CEPR or ceteris paribus, CEPR. What it means, there should not be any change in the prices of related goods, there should not be any change in the income of the consumer, there should not be any change in the taste preferences of the consumer or any other factor affecting demand for a commodity. Law of demand states keeping all the other factors constant, if the price of a commodity goes up, the quantity demanded will come down. If the price comes down, the demand will go up. In simple words, law of demand states the inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. That is opposite relationship between price and quantity demanded. I repeat, law of demand states keeping all the other factors constant. Law of demand shows the inverse relationship price and quantity, that is opposite relationship. If the price goes up, the demand will come down. If the price comes down, the demand will go up. We can explain law of demand with the help of a demand schedule and a demand curve. What exactly is demand schedule? A demand schedule shows in a tabular form, in a tabular statement, it shows different quantities demanded at different prices. Different quantities demanded at different prices. Look at the table here. Look at this one. When the price of the commodity is 2, the quantity demanded is 10. The price is very low too. Demand is 10. The price has gone up to 4. Look at the table. The quantity demanded has come down to 8. The price has demand has gone up to 6. And then it has gone up to 10. The quantity is coming down. 10, 8, 6, 4, 2. These are hypothetical figures. You take it here. Maybe 100, maybe 80, maybe 60, maybe 0. That, mind it, one thing. When the price goes up, the demand should come down. Our price comes down, the demand should go up. That shows the inverse relationship price and quantity demanded. What exactly is demand curve? Look at the graph here. A demand curve is a graphic representation of the demand schedule. It's a graphic representation of demand schedule. It also shows the same opposite relationship between price and quantity demanded. On the x-axis, we got quantity demanded in units. On the y-axis, we got the price of the commodity. The demand curve always slopes downwards. If it is sloping downwards, it shows the inverse of price and quantity demanded. Look at the graph here. So carefully, I go off the... When the price is OP, the quantity demanded is OQ. Now you can see it here clearly. The price has gone up from OP to OP1. You can see the arrow here. Obviously, the quantity has gone up from OQ to OQ2. The price has come down from OP to OP2. The quantity has come down from OQ to OQ2. So that's clearly. So law of demand states, keeping all the other factors constant, it shows the opposite of price and quantity demanded. What exactly is demand schedule? Demand schedule shows different quantities demanded by consumer at different prices over a given period of time. What exactly is demand curve? Demand curve is a graphic representation of demand schedule. So the demand curve is sloping downwards, showing the opposite relationship between price and quantity demanded. Law of demand states, other things remaining constant, as the price of the commodity goes up, its quantity demanded goes down and vice versa. It shows the inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. The law of demand is based on the following assumptions. What assumptions we take? Number one, assumptions of the law of demand. The law of demand operates only when we keep all all the other factors affecting demand constant except price. Therefore, there should not be any change in the price of related goods, that substitute goods and complementary goods. There shouldn't be any change in the income of the consumers. There shouldn't be any change in his taste, preferences and habits. The law of demand can be explained with the help of a demand schedule and demand curve. A demand schedule is a tabular statement which shows different quantities of a commodity demanded at different prices during a given period of time. The schedule shows as the price increases, quantity demanded falls, that is, inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. Look at this one, price 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. It's increasing. Quantity demanded is coming down 10, 8, 6, 4, 2. Look at the demand curve. That is, a demand curve reflects graphically the inverse relation between the quantity demanded of a commodity to its price. In the above figure, price is measured at OY axis and quantity demanded at OX axis. DD is the demand curve. It shows the opposite relationship between price and quantity demanded. When the price is OP, the quantity demanded is OQ. The price goes down from OP to OP2. The quantity has gone up from OQ to OQ2. The price has gone up from OP to OP1. Quantity has come down from OQ to OQ1. Mind it, demand curve is always downward sloping, showing the inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. That's all we have time for this short video, and this is an important concept in microeconomics. Understand it, because the understanding of this chapter helps you to understand the law of supply, equilibrium price, many other concepts in microeconomics. Thank you guys for watching. Till we meet next time, it's goodbye from Siddharam Sen. Don't forget to share, subscribe, like, comment, and press the bell icon to get future notifications and videos which are quite informative and educative, not only for this exam but for future exams. Till we meet next time, bye bye guys, take proper care, bye.